People come to the Outer Banks for a lot of different reasons.
My recipe to spice up a golf vacation: add liberal portions of sun, sand, surf, maybe a little bit of wind. That's what you'll get at the Outer Banks of North Carolina on this episode of The Traveling Golfer.
One moment changes everything. Distance, precision, decided in a microsecond. So reduce your ball spin and get the most performance at impact with 4 yards more. A next-gen golf tee proven by pros and players like you. The unique durable design flexes at contact, reducing ball spin, giving you tighter control and more distance. So change your game and get 4 yards more. Brought to you by Greenkeepers. Golf smart.
Are you tired of misreading putts? You read it to break left and it breaks right. With a Streckalign green reading book, you will know how your ball will roll on the green. Here is how you read it with the Streckalign arrows. Streckalign is used by touring pros, and now you can get the same book for your course. Save 50% today by using this promo code. Included with your purchase, you will get an instructional green reading video for free. So buy a book now so you can make more putts in your next round.
We're with Brian Sullivan, Director of Golf, here at Kilmarnock Golf Club, a real jewel in the entire Outer Banks area. I love this course, Brian. We're standing on the third tee. Tell us a little bit about the style of this course and this somewhat unknown architect, Tom Steele.
Tom Steele, this was the second course that he did. He did another one in Virginia called Nansman River. We were lucky to have Tom design the course. We're the last course that was built in the area. We had Tom here every day, and it really made the difference. And I think when people play this golf course, they can see the little things that were done that make the difference.
The name obviously makes you think that it might be a Scottish-Irish style course. Not really so. It's much more traditional Carolina course. It's a strategic golf course. Not only do you have to hit the ball away from the trouble, but on the right side of the fairway.
The way you come into the greens can make it a lot easier shot depending on where you play from. And Tom Steele did a great job giving you areas to hit to. They look sometimes narrow, but they're actually very forgiving and with a lot of room out there.
The entire golf course, I feel like as I'm playing the course, I'm playing a continuous story through and over the wetlands, strategic holes where there are carry bunkers, placement bunkers. I like the whole story that Kilmarnock tells me.
I think that's a great description of the golf course. People come in and ask, you know, to give them a little help on the course. I kind of describe it that way, and it's really a risk-reward course. I tell them you can kind of bite off whatever you want to bite off. And it's a course after people play it the first time, they can't wait to play it again because they feel like they can do so much better the next time. The finishing holes on this golf course are really something special. You get right near the sound, so you play along the marshes. Par 5, a par 3, and a par 5 as your finish. We host a collegiate event here at NC Division I. It's amazing those last three holes. You can have teams that are 3 or 4 shots in the lead, and after 18, they're 3 or 4 shots down. They're big swing holes. It's great fun to watch.
Yeah, strategic golf, Kilmarnock Golf Club, must play on any trip to the Outer Banks.
There's so much great golf in North Carolina. I mean, it is a state absolutely replete with great golf courses. And Kilmarnock has been recognized at the top.
Yes, thanks for mentioning that. We're a top 25 course in North Carolina that you can play. And we're very excited to have that recognition.
Kilmarnock's been here for a number of years. You have a beautiful development that has grown up around it. The houses do not intrude on the golf course at all. Now you decided that there was another little hole to fill. The cottages at Kilmarnock Golf Club, built to take care of golfers, right out the back door, putting green, a little 4-hole, teeny tiny short course.
With golf growing here on the Outer Banks and more groups coming to town, we figured we needed somewhere for them to stay. We did have one cottage that was being overly used, and guys needed more, wanted to bring more friends to the areas.
Now all of the places are designed the same again, thinking of the golfers. A large living room area with a big screen TV, a kitchen area so that if you don't want to go out, You can prepare everything here. And then two bedrooms downstairs, two bathrooms, and a large loft upstairs. So actually, these places could accommodate, say, two families. You have two master suites for the parents, and then you have that large loft. You can throw a bunch of kids up there.
Oh, yeah. It's large enough to hold a bunch of kids. You're right. Now that we have a water park less than a mile from our entrance, you know, we added the loft as a perfect place for families to get away in the summer. We've got golf, you've got the water park, and you got the beach.
Brian Kilmarlock, great golf, great hospitality. You proved it. You even brought us donuts this morning.
Yes, Tony, we take pride in our hospitality, and I couldn't let you leave town without having the iconic Duck Donuts. They're known throughout the South, and they started right here in Duck, North Carolina. And we've got three or four shops all up and down the Outer Banks. So don't leave here without trying them.
Tech Talk with Dave Glod, founder, president, Tour Edge Golf. You've put a lot of information out over the years. The golf geeks have to be getting back to you a lot and saying, here's what we like about Tour Edge. What is it?
I think the underlying factor is continued great quality and performance, but it's such a value. And they go, it only costs $200, really? And so that's wonderful, because that's the you know, that's our niche in that mid price point. So you get a great value, as good a product as anybody out there, but sometimes half the price.
The golf public has been hit with a lot of high costs, and they talk about the high costs. You're giving them an answer. That's our Tech Talk for this week on The Traveling Golfer.
Imagine a golf ball with the grip of a tire. Well, that's what you get with Bridgestone's new E12 Contact. Because the new Contact Force Dimple uses contact science technology similar to Bridgestone's high-performance tires, engineered to create 38% more contact at impact. For more distance and control, drive Bridgestone's new E12 Contact. Straight distance, driven by science.
We're with Chad Delia, golf professional here at the Carolina Club in Grandy, in the greater Outer Banks area. It's on the mainland. That's a good way to catch the travelers on their way in.
Correct.
And on the way out.
We get a lot of calls. People get stuck in traffic sometimes, but we get a few phone calls to make sure we're in the right spot for sure.
Tell a little bit about the style of the golf course.
Carolina Club's going to be a little bit more of a championship style golf course.
But sometimes there's a little bit of a break also.
For sure. Absolutely. Pretty open off the tee for the most part. Hole four here is a par five. Not too many hazards in play. Pretty short second shot, definitely a birdie hole. The ninth hole is also a birdie hole. There is some water in play, but it's pretty reachable in two, and that gives you a good look at eagle, if not a birdie, for sure.
Oh, I like hearing that eagle word. Aside from the birdie holes, I'm sure there's a couple you better pay attention to.
There's a few to keep your eye on. Hole seven is our par three island green. I'll just say that water's had a few golf balls in it every day. That's one thing. And then hole six is our toughest hole out here. Par five, hazards line both sides of the fairway all the way down the hole. And it's our longest hole out here as well. So
now when you're hard on the ocean, on the island, wind is always a factor. How about here?
It's definitely going to be a little bit of the same. We might have a little bit of the mainland wind, but a lot of the holes do have some water out there, so it does add a little challenge out there for your everyday golfer.
That's what we want, a little bit of challenge.
Absolutely.
We get it at the Carolina Club. We can always wash down some of that challenge inside there.
Tucker's Bar and Grill, you can't beat it. Definitely a good spot to stop by if you're in town.
with Corey Schneider, Director of Instruction at The Point on the Outer Banks, designed by Russell Breeden, who has done a lot of work in the Carolinas.
Yes, sir.
What are the main characteristics of this golf course?
The beauty of this golf course is it's always in great shape. We have a great staff that manicures the golf course. It's player friendly also. So if you're not the most polished golfer, you can still have fun out here and not lose a bunch of golf balls. And a lot of times people shoot one of their better scores at our golf course. Also, with the proximity of tee to green, the pace of play is quite fast. So a 4-hour round is a slow round for us. Going from number 5 to number 6 from that tee, you can actually see the sound, which is beautiful out there. Also on the back 9, you get to hole 16, you get to drive across a bridge, hit over a pond. It's got a nice little backdrop there.
The Point is located on the mainland. Pretty good course to start your trip to the Outer Banks.
It's always a nice one to kind of get you warmed up, especially those players that don't play every week. Not only here, but our sister course, the Carolina Club, which is just 10 minutes north. You're not going to go on an Easter egg hunt looking for your golf ball out here, which is nice.
And talking about good condition, the greens are really good for a good reason.
The greens are A1 bent grasses, which is exactly the same grass that you would see at Augusta National. They roll great, so it kind of takes an excuse away from you because they're always rolling good.
A little bit of Augusta right here at the Outer Banks. We're with Patrick Kelly, General Manager, Nags Head Golf Links, PGA member. He knows golf. He knows that golfers like to come and play a true links golf course, and Nags Head had a special rating, didn't it?
We were rated in the top 10 golf courses in America by Links Magazine Online for a links-style golf course. The course was developed in the late 80s here on a tract of land that's right along the Roanoke Sound.
And with the beach just across the street.
Correct. The beach is not much more than a half a mile across the street. So we're on a narrow strip of land here. Sandy soil, so it lended itself to a links-style golf course. Target course off the tee. Greens have some generous area for approach shots. Some of the natural grasses you would see in a links golf course, some of the beach grasses grow out here, so it gives that feel of a links style golf course for sure.
It's not a long course, so it's not going to overpower a lot of people, but you better be pretty accurate when you play.
Exactly. The golf course is just over 6,000 yards at its longest. It definitely requires accuracy over distance. If you play smartly to the middle of the fairways, you'll have middle irons to low irons into the greens all day. We struggle with storms. The sound here has salt content in the water, so we get overwash, and that's not very good for our Bermuda grass. It'll burn the Bermuda grass, but he works hard. He's got a great staff to keep the golf course in the condition that it's in.
Now, Patrick, we caught a very atypical day here at Nags Head Golf Links. Pretty calm.
Yeah, this is very unusual to have a flagstick lay limp without any breeze on it. Typically this time of year you'll see a southwest wind blowing across the golf course, making club selection very difficult. If you've never played the golf course before, there are some blind shots, some areas you have to lay up off the tee, and then just a few rounds under your belt out here so you understand the way the golf course plays, and then it becomes a very scoreable golf course.
Now, this course is managed by Club Corp, a national management company.
Correct.
Advantages?
Yeah, we manage this golf course here on the Outer Banks at Nags Head Golf Links. We also manage the Currituck Club in Kerala. Our members have access to hundreds of golf courses across the country. Membership here has great benefits for them to travel and see golf courses all over the country.
A lot of history at Nags Head. A lot of golf balls in that Roanoke Sound. A lot of fun. I recommend this stop right here.
Oh, that spin class was brutal.
Well, you can try using the Buick's massaging seat.
Ooh, yeah, that's nice.
Can I use Apple CarPlay to put some music on?
Sure, it's wireless.
Pick something we all like.
Okay, hold on.
What's your Buick's Wi-Fi password?
Buick Envision 2021.
Oh, you should pick something stronger. That's really predictable.
That's a really tight spot.
Don't worry, I used to hate parallel parking.
Me too.
Hey.
Really outdid yourself.
Yes, we did.
The all-new Buick Envision, an SUV built around you, all of you.
With Michelle Ellis, Public Relations Coordinator for Currituck County Tourism Board. That's on the northern end of the Outer Banks, where there's a very famous area known as Corolla. where they have wild horses.
On our four-wheel drive beach, that is where our wild Spanish Mustang roam. And those horses have been there for about 500 years. They came over with the Spaniards. The ships crashed on the coast. The horses have actually acclimated themselves to our area, and they're one of our iconic treasures for our county. We have our historic Ralla Lighthouse, the Whalehead, which is actually a historic house that you can tour, and at one time it was a hunting lodge.
There's a special center in Corolla for wildlife education.
It's called the Outerbanks Center for Wildlife Education.
The other thing is, though, there is some shopping up in that area.
We've got a place called Historic Corolla Village. We have the Wild Horse Museum is actually in Historic Corolla Village.
For something different, try the north end of the Outerbanks. We're sitting on the patio, a beautiful sunny day in the Outer Banks of North Carolina with JT Simmons, Director of Golf at the Currituck Club in Corolla, and see this club built right close to the ocean by the great Reese Jones. He did an exceptional piece of architecture on the Currituck Club.
No question, you know, took a piece of property without moving a bunch of land, built it, took what I would call very diverse conditions agronomically to build that golf course, and took great advantage of the landscape, wildlife, and the views, sound and ocean. You're going to have a challenging golf course that's straightforward right in front of you. There's no tricky, goofy holes at the Currituck Club. Straightforward, very picturesque, but definitely a premium off the tee. You're going to have hazards on every hole, but at the same time, you'll be rewarded for making smart plays off the tee.
There's some nice roll to it, and I guess it's because it's a bit of links land in there.
And where the clubhouse sits, it sits on top of what once was a dune. And you drop back in, come back up, drop back in, come back up. So varied landscape, which is unusual.
Now there is some good and interesting bunkering throughout the golf course. We've seen that, but not overpowering, I wouldn't say.
No, you have a blend of typical Reese Jones, where he's putting them in the places that are reasonable for a bunker to be in as well. There's some good visual bunkers that are appeasing to the eye in some of those complexes, without question.
Terrific greens at the Currituck Club. Being close to the ocean, the airflow makes it possible for anyone bent, and you folks manage it throughout the year.
We're kind of in a transition zone where you probably go Bermuda or bent grass. I think you'll find a handful of both, depending on the preference. We take care of, manage them, hand syringe in the hot months, and obviously in the fall and the winter and the spring, they thrive. You know, firm, fast. We do a great job with them. We have a great staff that takes excellent job of our greens.
Yeah. Now it's time for the Strack-A-Line putt of the day. There's a lot of deception built into these Reese Jones greens at the Currituck Club. And remember, the ocean is close by. You know what they say, ball always breaks toward the water. Strack-A-Line reminds you. Some people just like to come to the Outer Banks and hang out. Aaron Toole, Public Relations Manager for the Outer Banks Visitors Bureau, 130 miles. This is his kingdom. A lot of different attractions for people all across this long stretch of North Carolina coast.
The Cape Hatteras National Seashore, which is the largest tract of undeveloped beaches on the East Coast. What other development in human history has affected modern travel more than the invention and the development of the airplane? And you can visit Kitty Hawk, Kill Devil Hill's Wright Brother National Memorial, and actually walk the flight line where the Wright brothers took off and landed. We have the tallest sand dunes on the East Coast at Jockeys Ridge State Park. It's a free state park. You can learn how to hang glide there, and we've got things to do. There's three national parks, a state park, and two wildlife refuges. About 80% of our accommodations come from that vacation rental industry. Thousands of homes where two and three families can kind of come in, split the cost.
Yeah, and they go from the smaller cottage size to some massive homes right on the beach where the extended family can stay.
So it's really a year-round destination. So everything that you love about the Outer Banks in the summertime applies to the fall too, except it's just a little bit less busy. The rates come down a little bit after the kids go back to school.
Free parking,
free beaches. Even the air is free, and there's plenty of air on the Outer Banks.
That's right.
There's always a breeze. It's the coolest place in North Carolina.
When you talk golf in the Outer Banks, you gotta talk to the head man, Keith Hall, president of the Outer Banks Golf Association, owner of the Carolina Club and the Point Golf Club. A couple different hats, you wear them well.
Making great strides and trying to get more and more people to come to the Outer Banks and recognize it as a true golf destination. When you're on the beach, for example, you've got the wind coming into major play. Instead of a 6-iron, you got to hit 4-iron many times. Some are on the mainland, all unique, and they all offer a different style of play, and we are able to keep bent grass here. It's cool enough. It's the cool breezes off the ocean. I would bet that North Carolina's Outer Banks are one of the coolest spots to be in the summertime playing golf.
Play golf during the day, go out and have a feast at night.
Yes.
And they're not always looking for the 5-star experience where you have to get dressed up. The Outer Banks seems to me to be a golfer's delight. Incredible fresh seafood and so many other choices.
We have a lot of family-owned businesses versus chains. You can find a little hole-in-the-wall bar that serves great oysters or fried shrimp, many times caught right here or near the Outer Banks. And barbecue, of course, North Carolina style has the vinegar base. You can still get great barbecue here, many, many places.
You've seen all the golf courses here. How about machine gun style, a little one-liner on each of the courses?
Let's start with Nags Head Links. Beautiful views of the Sound in particular, close to the ocean. Bring your knockdown shot. Currituck Club, beautiful venue. Clubhouse is spectacular. Great driving range. Reese Jones design, which you just can't beat. Kilmarnock, I think they've hosted several tournaments here. Beautiful, challenging course. Awesome greens. Love Kilmarnock. R2, The Point, which is, we tout as very well conditioned and fun and playable. Won't beat you up as much as some of the other courses, which I consider more championship. And the Carolina Club, which is our longer course, we have so many tees to play that any type of golfer can enjoy that course, even though it's long.
The Outer Banks, steeped in history. The beaches, sand dunes, wild horses, deep sea fishing, all of the family attractions. It's a long list, but at the top of the list, you must put golf. This may look like the desert, but it's actually an oasis, a golf and vacation oasis. Killdevil Hills, smack in the middle of the Outer Banks. A place where surf life and turf life live in perfect harmony, allowing us to enjoy nature's greatest blood pressure pill. And we'll see you on a future episode of The Traveling Golfer.
Official sponsors of The Traveling Golfer include Bridgestone, providing distance, feel, and accuracy from tee to green. Tour Edge, equipment that gives you the leading edge both in price and performance. Swing Dish and Covell, fresh new apparel making you look great on and off the golf course.